Hi everyone, Richard here. Well, the numbers are in for the Real Estate Board of Greater Vancouver for the month of April. So I want to talk about what's going on in your marketplace, hoping this will help you inform your clients better. But at the end, what I'd like to do is I want to talk about something I printed out from your board, and I'm going to suggest that you might consider using when you're on a presentation. So first of all, let's get into the numbers. So if we look here, you can see in January, sales were 1,800. February were about 2,200. March were about 2,500. And then April, again, you know, just above 2,500. So March and April was very, very close, which is a little bit unusual because usually April is stronger than March, but I'll talk about that in a minute. Active listings, of course, rising 7,000 roughly in January, 7,800 in February, 8,300 in March. You know, we got up to almost 10,000 in the month of April. But here's the big number, months of inventory, right? Which, of course, is taking the amount of sales and dividing it into the active listings that are on the market right now. And you can see we're at 3.8. February 3.5, March 3.3, and then of course it went up a little bit in April to 3.8, back to what it was in January, which again is a little bit unusual. But here's, you know, the good news. The good news is, if you look at your benchmark price here, 1.06, 1.07 in February, 1.08 in March, and of course 1.09 in April. So actually your prices, you know, are still going up. Now, not all properties are going up, don't get me wrong, and I'll talk more about that in a minute, but if we look sort of the average price, they are. And the reason being is because if you just look at months of inventory here, when you have below 4 months of inventory, okay, what you're going to see is you're going to see more of a seller's market, again, depending on property type. But when we get up above 5 months of inventory, we're going to start to see more of a buyer's market, you know, especially we got up around six. So sort of 4 to 5, around there, maybe up to six, is more of a balanced market. So what I want to do now is I want to talk a little bit about the difference between this year and last year. So April of 18 to April of 17, you can see our sales were off by 27%. Look at active listings, they're up by 25%, which obviously means we're going to have more inventory. So we got 3.8 months of inventory opposed to 2.2. However, look at your composite benchmark price, still up, okay, by about $500,000. So in terms of price, it's positive, right? It's up by 14%. So if you look at everything that's going on right now, there's a lot of uncertainty in your marketplace. Now, the market is fine. Certain markets are challenged a little bit more, and I'm going to show you some of those in just a moment. But I think the key is this. You've got to look at it and you say, you know, right now, obviously the foreign buyer tax had an effect, but also there's a lot of other taxes, sort of the land transfer tax and more expensive homes. Obviously, you got sort of the vacancy tax for people that say aren't living in a property and they're not renting it out, if you will, and they own it and they're from another province. And what's happening is the government is saying, guess what? You're going to have to pay tax on that as well because you're not generating revenue for our province. So you've got a lot of things happening right there. And just that alone, think about this. Somebody's in Calgary. They own a vacation property in BC. And of course, they don't rent it out, it is their own place. Maybe the property's worth $2 million, and they look at it and say, well, you know, the tax is going to cost me literally thousands of dollars every single month. So maybe what I need to do is sell the property, which is going to add to inventory. So let's have a look at different property types, because this is very interesting. We've got detached, we've got apartments, condo apartments, and we've got townhouses up here. So you can see that you have 7 months of inventory in detached properties. Now, if you have 7 months of inventory in detached properties, what's going to be happening to those prices? They're going to be weakening. Now, the most inexpensive detached properties are probably doing just fine, but the luxury market is probably getting killed right now because you have so much inventory. You got 7 months of inventory. Condo apartments, we only got 2.1 months of inventory. Townhouses, we got 2.8. So I think it's pretty easy to say that this is probably the year of condos, right? Because people can afford condos. You're probably still getting multiple offers on many condos and many townhouses and lower price detached homes. Now what I want to do is I want to get in to this information. When you're meeting with a buyer, when you're meeting with a seller, I think what you have to do is you got to break these markets down so they understand what is going in their market. So I just happened to pick two markets, but I printed this out from the board, and you can see it's got Burnaby, Coquitlam, it's got them all right along here, but I did North Van and I did West Van because extreme markets. So let's look at this. We look at West Vancouver. The month of April, 32 sales. 521 listings, 16.3 months of inventory. What do you think's happening in West Vancouver? Prices are going down fairly quickly, okay, aggressively, because we have 16 months of inventory. Crazy number. Why do we have 16 months of inventory? Because our average price is $3 million. So the higher the price, when the market starts to change, the more it's going to be affected. So let's look at this. 3.1 average price. Let's look at North Van. It's 1.8. What's going on in that market? 77 sales, active listings, 391, 5.1 months of inventory, which is more of a balanced market. So here's the message. Your market is changing a little bit right now. My prediction, you're still in great shape. I think it's going to be relatively stable for the rest of this year. Yes, there's a lot of uncertainty, but we got to keep this in mind. Unemployment in Canada is low. It's just slightly below 6%, which is a great number. And unemployment is the big one we got to look at. Second thing, it is said we're going to have about 300,000 people come to Canada this year. 300,000 people are coming to Canada. Where do you think many of them are going to end up? They're going to end up in Toronto and they're going to end up in Vancouver, right? Many other cities as well, but that's where most of them are going to end up. So the deal is this. We still have very unemployment. We still have high immigration. So with those two things and inflation being under control, with those two things, what's happening is our market is trying to figure its way out right now because of all the changes that are being made by the government, right? You know, the market's saying, hey, what's going on? And when I say the market, I mean buyers and sellers. You know, sellers are saying, I got a vacation property in BC, maybe I need to sell it. They put it on the market, adds to the inventory, right? Maybe takes a little longer to sell. If it's very expensive, it's probably going down in price, which means now it's probably a good time to sell opposed to a couple months from now. You own a condominium. If you're, say, downtown Vancouver or maybe you're somewhere else, well, probably going to go up, you know, for the rest of this year. But here's what you need to do. When you're meeting with a buyer, you're meeting with a seller, you need to take this information. And you need to not talk about the general market because generalizing isn't giving them the correct information. But breaking down in their market. So let's say that we're talking a certain area of Vancouver. Well, what you want to do is you want to take them, what's going on? How many months of inventory in that market? Are prices going up? Are prices going down? How many sales? How many active listings? And then break it down by property type. So if I'm meeting with somebody that has a detached property, that's the information I should show them. Condo, apartment, that's the information I should show them. And again, you can get all this information from your board, which I'm sure you already know. So I hope this was helpful. I look forward to talking to you again next month, and let's see what the market holds next month. But it's still a very wonderful market to be working in. And remember, it's a beautiful life, everybody. Make it count.